In this example, we are going to solve active earth pressure condition for a wall with sandy backfill with the given properties. We are going to solve it for three types of conditions: when the backfill is completely dry, when the backfill is completely saturated, and the third one, if the groundwater table is at 4 meters below the ground surface. Let us do it step by step. The first thing we have to do is to calculate coefficient of active earth pressure, or K sub A. We have seen that that is equals to tan square 45 minus phi over 2. Now in this case, phi is given as 36 degrees, so we can substitute that. So we are going to get tan square 45 minus 36 over 2, which we get it as 0.26. Just a note here, the other day we have seen the coefficient of at rest condition K naught or K sub 0, that is given as 1 minus sine phi, and if you remember, we calculated that as 0.41. So K active happens to be lower than K naught. That is just to remember. Now let us get started. So the first condition is when backfill is completely dry. So dry backfill. As we have seen earlier, the first step is to find the vertical effective stress. So you have a wall which is 8 meters in height. This is 8 meters. And we have to draw the vertical effective stress first. So we have vertical effective stress sigma v prime, that is equals to 8 multiplied by 17, that is the unit weight, dry unit weight, which is equals to 136 kilopascals. There is no pore water pressure. So all we are going to do is just directly calculate now active earth pressure. So active earth pressure diagram is going to be same as vertical effective stress diagram, except this part is going to be active earth pressure, so sigma sub A, and then that is going to be equals to 8 multiplied by 17, that is the vertical effective stress, multiplied by K active. This value we know, it is 0.26. so this is equals to 136 multiplied by 0.26, which is equals to 35.36 kilopascals. Now this is the lateral stress diagram. Now we can calculate the thrust. Thrust is given by the area of this lateral stress diagram, and that thrust acts at the centroid of this diagram. Okay, so P sub A or the active lateral thrust or the force, that is going to be half multiplied by 8 multiplied by 35.36, which works out to be 141.44. The units are going to be kilonewton per meter length, and it is going to act at a third from the base, which is equals to 2.67 meters. Part B, when the backfill is completely saturated, now in this case again the procedure is same. We have to first draw the vertical effective stress diagram, add the pore water pressure separately, and then find the lateral stress. So this is the wall. Now in this case, when it is completely saturated, meaning the water table is at the top and this soil is saturated, so you will need to know the saturated unit weight, which is 21.81 kilonewton per meter cube. Again, this height is 8 meters. So let us draw the vertical effective stress diagram. So for this wall, we have vertical effective stress at the base, sigma prime v can be calculated as 8 multiplied by 21.81 minus 9.81, which is equals to 96 kilopascals. Now you can calculate the pore water pressure separately. So this was sigma V diagram or the vertical stress diagram. Let us draw the pore water stress diagram, which is nothing but again one more triangle, and this part of the, at the pore water stress at the base is going to be equals to 8 multiplied by 9.81, which is equals to 78.48 kilopascals. This is U diagram or pore water pressure diagram. Now based on these two, we can also calculate the lateral stress diagram. Always remember, vertical stress will be multiplied by active earth pressure coefficient, but pore water pressure remains the same. So lateral stress diagram is going to look like we have again a triangle. Where you have at the base, you have 96 multiplied by K sub A, this is K A, so that is equals to 24.96 kilopascals, and in addition to that you have pressure due to water, which is 78.48. So the total distance at the base, or the total stress at the base, is equals to 103.44 kilopascals. Now, just we have done in earlier cases, we can calculate the thrust, which is going to be equals to area of the pressure diagram. This will act from the 1/3 of the height from the base. So lateral thrust is 413.76 kilonewton per meter. So in the first case, you had, when the soil was dry, the lateral thrust was 141.44. In the second case, when it is completely saturated, it is 413.76. So with the water, the lateral thrust is increased considerably.